all we can on this angry father.
Dr. Grace, hey.
Oh, hi, Jess. Nick.
Hey, what brings you out here?
She leads our grief group.
She also agreed to help us with the Miller case.
Yes, anything I can do. And as long as I'm here, consider this a friendly reminder that you still owe me a mandatory psych evaluation post-fight club.
Oh, please. I really don't need evaluating.
Just get it done, Torres.
Which would make you Agent Parker?
The graceful Dr. Grace.
You two don't know each other?
Crazy, right? How many months has it been since he joined NCIS? And Parker still owes me a prelim psych eval.
I've been a little busy.
Oh, just get it done, Parker.
I will. I happen to love therapy.
Not therapy, just an evaluation.
Then I love that too. But first, anything yet on our petty officer?
Quite a bit, actually. Here's the crew from Commander Miller's last flight originating out of camp in the Meunier. That is Petty Officer Jordan standing next to Miller.
She really is just a kid.
Yeah, their youngest member, which is why her loss was so hard on Tommy.
Yeah, enough to send him to therapy with you 3 days out of the week.
Three?
That's what his wife said.
Tommy attended our weekly groups, but I had only 2 private sessions with him in the last 4 months.
If he lied to his wife about that, what else is he lying about?
Well, here's one possible answer. Miller received 8 calls from the same blocked number in the past 2 days.
I trust you unblocked it.
And already traced it to an R. Jordan of Falls Church, Virginia.
Father of our dead petty officer?
You got him here. He's listed as Richard Jordan, 62, widowed. And according to his records, the restraining order Miller took out on him expired just last week.
So, who's up for a chat with Dad?